paresseux, les voleurs, les voleurs.
Thomas Sankara was a Marxist-Leninist Pan-Africanist revolutionary who served as the president of Burkina Faso from 1983 to 1987. Often seen as the Che Guevara of Africa, Sankara was an icon of African solidarity and progress, and his accomplishments during his presidency show nothing but the strength and collaboration of the people of Burkina Faso. He came into power through a military coup d'etat in 1983 and renamed the country from the French colonial name Upper Volta to Burkina Faso, meaning the land of the upright people. Immediately after coming into power, he enacted various projects based around philosophies of agrarian socialism and planted over 10 million trees, decentralized food production, and in turn made the country completely food self-sufficient. His campaign succeeded in building medical centers in over two-thirds of all villages and built over 350 schools, increasing the literacy rate from 13% to 73% within just 4 years. Unfortunately, Thomas Sankara was killed in another coup d'etat in 1987 led by his own friend, Blaise Compaoré, who had reversed nearly all of Sankara's policies and controlled Burkina Faso until 2014. But community, degrowth, revolution, and faith was the legacy that Thomas Sankara left behind in the spirits of the Burkinabe people.
Hey guys, we are back. Well, I'm back again. I don't know about anybody else, but hey, this is Miss Williams, Dr. Williams, if you know me that way. Well, do you hear that? Listen, do you hear that? Sounds like a heartbeat. But did you know exactly who the heartbeat of our school is? Guys, I'm so excited to introduce you to these people. These are the ones that make our campus great. Hi, Miss Floor.
Hi.
What is your favorite thing about Peyto?
My job, I love it. I like dealing with our kids. They're fantastic. And I also love our staff.
Oh, that is so kind of you. I know you love dealing with me because I'm the best. I have Ms. Vasquez, your 10th grade secretary. What is your favorite thing about this Peyto campus?
Oh, well, I would say working with the students and just watching them grow.
Miss Miriam Stewart, how are you?
Great.
Okay. Well, we thank you for everything that you do for our athletes. Can you name, I know we got a lot of head coaches here at our campus, but can you at least name five of them?
Yes. We have Coach Hicks, we have Coach Stroman, Coach Nimi, Coach Castorena, we have Coach Baker, Coach Brown. Am I past my five?
You have a lot of coaches.
You are, and I know that you can name all your coaches.
I know, you work very hard.
It's Miss Seidel. Another person who is the heartbeat of our school. Well, she's the money person of our school, to be honest. You opened Peyto.
I did open Peyto.
So tell us about that. How was that experience?
Well, it was interesting because in the beginning, there was nothing here. Like none of these buildings, houses, businesses were here. We had no place to eat. There was no Chick-fil-A. There was no Whataburger, and it just was open land. So it's amazing to see how much the school has grown. We started out with 700 kids. That's all we had.
Wow.
And now we have over 3,200. So it's interesting. I love seeing the growth that Peyto's had.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dr. Paz, principal of Peyto High School. This is, I think, my 22nd year in education. I started out in elementary. I was a fourth grade teacher, then decided elementary wasn't for me. Then I was principal in 2013 for May Creek Junior High, where I met a lot of our Peyto students that are here now. And then 2 years ago in 2021, I opened Haskett Junior High, and now I am here is your principal. The plans for the rest of this year is really to build relationships, get to know students. I've had some great conversations and really kind of developing different structures just to maintain and improve safety, academics. You know, what I want to do is be a part of the culture of Peyto and really just keep supporting our students, our staff, and continue to make this a great school for everybody.
My name is Julian Onazing. I used to go to May Creek, and Dr. Pazzo is my principal. I feel like he's a very great principal, and he respects everyone the same way. So I feel like we should be able to respect him and show him that we can, you know, lead this school the right way.
Hi, my name is Elazar. I went to May Creek Junior High in eighth grade with Sergio over here, and we had Dr. Paz as our eighth grade principal. He was a pretty good principal. He was understanding, pretty chill, and honestly, I think he was a pretty fun principal. He kept us safe, and you know, he did things that he was supposed to, and of course, you know, he did fun stuff, like he dressed up as a Pokemon trainer one time. I know it's a little cringy, but he was a pretty good principal.
My name is Sergio Almaguer. I used to go to May Creek Junior High, where Dr. Paul was my principal, and he was a pretty cool guy. I remember him, you know, walking in the hallways playing Pokemon Go. I thought he was like our coolest principal ever. So I think, you know, he's definitely going to be a real good change to this school. And you know, SS Panthers, we should show him, you know, welcome him. So yeah.
Coming soon on next week's episode of Panther TV.
Hey Panthers, my name is Ghazali. I'm the varsity tennis captain, and today I'm gonna be teaching some Panther TV members how to play.
You may know Serena, and you may also know Venus, but who you don't know is Gabrielle Barnes. I'm most athletic, and I'm about to whoop everybody's butt. Go Panthers.
Hey, it's Giselle. Is you good? Is you great? Because I want to know. I'm going to beat Gabby. Simple.